In this video, you are going to learn everything you need to know to build in Base44. Base44 was recently acquired by Wix for $80 million, and it's one of the fastest growing AI app builders. It has a lot of useful features, including a fully integrated system, so the database and user authentication is all done automatically through Base44, so you don't have to connect any other external services. You can think of it kind of like Wix or Squarespace for AI app building. So we're going to go start to finish. The first thing that you should know about Base44 is they have really helpful features to help you write your initial prompt. So the first thing that we can do is decide what app category we want to do. So let's say we want to build a productivity app and we want to build a goal tracking app. So right off the bat, Base44 is going to have a pre-written prompt for us, which is really helpful. So it's really helpful to get started. And then with styling instructions, Base44 is going to help us basically write into our prompt what the style could look like. So if we click neo-brutalism, for example, and add those style instructions, it adds that to the prompt. So these are things that are really helpful because the result of what you get from AI is really as only as good as the input that you're going to give it. The other thing is you can upload files to your Base44 prompt. I'm not going to do that here, but just know that is an option. And then I'm going to go ahead and send this away. So what you need to know now is Base44 is going to start building out the initial version of your app. On the left side, you can see it's basically planning it out with the features, design language, and app organization. And you can see in real time what it's working on. On the right side, it is going to basically be creating your app. And this initial app creation is what takes the longest. So feel free, go get a coffee, relax, come back in maybe about 5 minutes. Of course, I'm just going to pause the video and come back so you can skip all of that. And here we are. We have our first version of the app. I'm really impressed with the design that Base44 was able to create. This is actually really good and really different from what I've seen most other AI app builders create. So let's just run through it together real quick. On the top, we have our goals, what's completed, what's active, and progress. You can filter your goals, it looks like. And then it looks like it also created some sample goals that basically we can take a look at before we actually have real data in our database. And let's see what happens. Can I edit it? So then we can see what it looks like. If we edit, you can change the progress level and update it. You can add progress, so just add 25%, add 10%, and then when it's done, it creates this like bouncing success pop-up, which is cool, although kind of hard to exit out of. You have to time it. And overall, I am pretty impressed. I'm going to walk through some important things you should know about the Base44 dashboard now that we have our first version. So on the top, first of all, there is a version history, so you can see all the history and revert back based on new things that we create. You can view it on mobile view and on desktop view. So this is really helpful as well to make sure that your app looks good on all platforms. The main thing that I want to go over is we have the preview and the dashboard tab here. So this is really important. The preview is where you can see what your app actually looks like. The dashboard tab is where you manage many aspects of your app. And this is really what sets Base44 apart. So first of all, there's an overview tab where you can change your visibility to public, private, with login or not login. You can invite people to your app. You can browse all the users. Right now it's just me, but as people sign up and use your app, this is where the users will show up. And this is what I mean by the database being integrated. There's also this goal, basically, of the goal table in the database. So it automatically created this. And this is what I mean by it added these by default, which is cool, just so you could see what your app looks like as opposed to it being blank. There's analytics, so you can see what is happening on your app. Having this built in is pretty cool. Domains, you can either purchase a domain or integrate a domain you already have so that it can be on your own custom domain. There's a security check. This is something that's really important. You want to make sure that you don't have any security vulnerabilities when you are releasing your app. So this is a helpful tab to have. Under the code tab, you can see all of the code that your app has. The API tab, this is where it gets a little bit more technical, but you're able to see the API integrations that have been created. Settings, logo, app settings. I want to quickly call out there's some more advanced features here. One of them is backend functions. if you activate this, you do have to be on a paid plan of Base44 right now. By doing this, you're going to be able to connect to any backend API. So if you want to connect to Stripe, for example, for payments, I have a video about that where we go into more detail about activating these backend connections. And then for authentication, this is how users sign in and sign up for your app. By default, the email and password in Google is turned on, but you can also turn on Microsoft, Facebook, or turn them off as well. So those are just some kind of key things to know about the settings and how this is all set up in Base44. So the next thing that I want to show you how to do is add that ability for users to log in and sign up for your app so everyone can have their own goals page. And this is something that is going to be really transferable for just about any app you're going to want to build in Base44. So let's now add user authentication so users can sign in and sign up to access their own goals. Also create a landing page for logged out users. So we'll go ahead and have it start working on that. And you're going to want to stick around because in a minute, I'm going to go over the visual edit and discuss features, which are really helpful in Base44. So we now have user authentication, and you can see because I'm logged in, there's now a logout button. So why don't we test this out by opening in a new tab where I'm not logged in? So I'm going to go up to the top and click on publish. And then down, we can see this is a temporary domain that the app is published on. So I'm going to copy that. Then I'm going to go into an incognito tab, paste it in. And here we have our landing page, basically. So this is just a basic landing page that it created where the user can log in. So why don't I click sign up and let's test this out. And we'll create an account. It sent me a verification email. So let me check my email for that. I pasted in the code. I'm going to verify. And now it's redirecting me and now I can log in. And here we go. I am now logged in as a brand new user. It has a state where the user has no goals yet, which is really great. So I can now create my first goal. So let's say I'm going to go to the gym for get in great shape. And let's say go to the gym. Category can be health, priority can be high. Target date, why don't we say October 8th? And we will create that goal. And there we go. Now I have a goal. And this is only my account because I'm logged in as a new user. So I promised I would talk about the visual editing and discuss features. These are really important for you to understand about Base44. So let's start with the discuss feature. What discuss allows you to do is ask the AI a question, and the AI will think about it, look at your code base, and respond without actually making changes in your app. So let's say I want to ask, what do you think I should create next? So this is just asking the AI a question. It is then going to, again, look at the code and then respond based on that. So here's what it thinks: add milestones or subtasks to goals, add advanced goal analytics and visualization, user-defined goal templates. Which direction would I like to explore next? Okay, so I'm going to do that in a second. Now, before I do that, I want to talk about what the visual edit is. So if I click on visual edit, now when I put my cursor on the preview, you can see that it's highlighting different parts of the app. So let's click on, for example, the headline. When I click on that headline, I can now make changes. So let's say I just put a bunch of exclamation points here. I can also change a lot of different things about the app or about that styling of the section. If I hit save, now that's going to manually save. I can also revert, but this is now updated. So I can make updates visually without having to actually type and ask the AI what to do. This allows me to make more refined changes on the app, which I think is very helpful. So now let's remove discuss and why don't we have it do another one of these features? So let's say, why don't we say add milestone and subtasks? So let's say let's add milestones as the next feature and let's see what it is able to do. Okay, so Base44 has completed this. It also updated our existing tasks to add milestones, which is pretty cool. And I like the design that it did for this. So like run a 10K. Buy shoes, run a 5K, run a 7K, register for the race. What I want to do is let's go ahead and click edit and just see what it did. So it added these milestones. So this is something you can edit, you can delete, you can add more milestones. And then when you add a new goal, this is something that you can add as well. Okay, very cool that it was able to do that. The next thing that I want to do is show you the integrations that Base44 has. This is another thing that I find that makes Base44 really powerful. What I mean by that are integrations that you can add to your Base44 app without having to create an account on a different service. So that includes OpenAI, so you can add AI functionality, Slack, SMS with Twilio, resend email. So there's a lot of different things you can add directly into Base44. So what I want to do is, let's say I'm adding a goal and I add it. I want there to be a way for the milestones to be added automatically using AI. So let me write the prompt for that. So the prompt is, I want to add an AI integration when a user creates a new goal, it uses AI to automatically come up with the milestones. So it added this functionality. It looks like there's a generate with AI button now. And remember, we did not create an OpenAI account or anything. It's all integrated into Base44. So let's try one. Let's say run a marathon. I want to run a marathon in New York City. So category, this can be health. Priority, let's say hi. Target date, let's say it's November 30th. And then now let's try generating with AI and let's see how well it works. All right, this is cool. Register for the New York City Marathon, create a weekly training schedule, increase weekly distance by 10%, half marathon, proper nutrition and hydration leading up to marathon day. Pretty cool that it was able to do this. And of course, you can edit them if you'd like. Now we can create the goal. And here we go. So now that goal is created with our milestones. And you can also check them off, which I just did. And the last thing that you should know is, when you're ready for others to actually use the app or to publish it onto your own domain, you just have to go up to the top, click Publish App, and then your domain will be updated with the latest version. And again, if you want to add a custom domain, just go to your dashboard into domains. Again, security is really important. I'll start that security check. This is something that you'd want to do before actually putting your app into the wild and having other people use it. I hope that you found this video useful. If you've made it this far, you know everything that you need to know to start building in Base44. You understand all the important features and functionality, and you can modify what you learned in this video to whatever your app idea is. Check out our video on integrating Stripe if you want to add payment functionality to Base44, and click the link in the description to go to Base44 and start building yourself. There's a free plan so you can get started completely for free without a credit card. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more free content like this, and leave a comment below to let me know if Base44 is something that you could see yourself using. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you in the next video.